brothers and sisters in Islam, how much does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do for us? He created us. He gave us life. He gave us good health. He gave us wealth. He gave us children. He gave us wives and spouses. He gave us beautiful homes to live in. He promises for us an eternal paradise. He will elevate our status and let us look at His face on the Day of Judgment. How does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love us so much? It's shown by the fact that even when we disobey Him, He still feeds us. He still clothes us. He still lets us breathe. But Allah, He still provides for us and nourishes us and sustains us. Even whilst we're disobeying Him, but Allah, even when we're committing that sin, Allah is still letting us breathe. Allah is still letting us eat our food. Ya Salaam. How great and how noble and how merciful is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
How is it so that Abu Bakr, as the Amir, as the head of a state, he would travel every day after Fajr to a blind elderly woman's house and clean her house and prepare her children, tend to her animals, and yet she didn't even know who he was, who this man was? What about Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu? What about him? He was on his way to kill the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, to kill the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and instead he accepted Islam, and his love for Allah Azza wa Jal and his deen was so great that while all the other Muslims were hiding their Islam, he was ready to proclaim his Islam. What about Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu wa ardah? What about him when he was asked to give? When he gave, my dear brothers and sisters, he gave from the best of what we had. Uthman ibn Affan, he gave the best of what he had in all of what he had, or as much as he could. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, the Sahaba said that they left him after Isha in Ruku' and they came before Fajr and they found him in Ruku', except there was one difference. There was one difference. That his beard was soaked. His beard was soaked and there was a puddle beneath him. Ya Allah, Ya Allah.
But Allah, you are special. You are special. He created you and you're more valuable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the Kaaba. Wallahi, the scholars of Islam say, the tears of a believer are more precious than the Kaaba's. Hakada qala shawkani. My brothers, my sisters in Islam, one day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam stood up in the depths of the night. It is authentically reported in Al-Bukhari that he raised his hands up to the heavens and he said, Oh Allah, my Ummah, my Ummah. Ya Allah, my Ummah, my Ummah. Ya Allah, my Ummah, my Ummah. He couldn't say more than that. He couldn't finish his sentences because he was so emotional. Until the night passed and the last third of the night came, until Fajr time came. And at that point, Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam came down and said, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah has sent me and said, Ya Muhammad, your Lord will not disappoint you regarding your Ummah. Your Lord will not disappoint you regarding your Ummah. The question is, brothers and sisters in Islam, are we going to disappoint our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What is it that you have done to prove to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you love Him? To prove to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He asks you on the Day of Judgment, Ya Abdi, O my slave, how have you proven that you love me so that I may love you back on this day? Be you of those people who fulfill his vision. Be you of those people who fulfill your love for Allah Azza wa Jal by pursuing the vision of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on this earth.
Ask yourself, do you love Allah?